Alala Wasala this evening.
While I'm talking, there's a beautiful kudu bull lying down in the shade. It's a very hot day today. Somehow I think it's hotter, actually. Herman, what do you think?
Than yesterday?
Yeah, I think it's hotter than yesterday.
Yeah, it does feel hotter than yesterday.
It's hard to sort of get nitpick about the heat when one day is 41 and another day is 42, but it is a little bit hotter today. Hey, look at this kudu bull, he's just... Flat kudu. When did we last see a flat kudu? I don't think I've seen a kudu lying down like that since very cold temperatures in winter. Ah, here we go, here's Warren. Go ahead, Warren.
Well, okay, we're going to switch off the power again.
Okay, thanks, Warren. Alright, thanks a lot, bud. Alright, there we go. Message from Fuyatela. They've got to switch off the power again and work on some wires. So, Patrick will take you to Gari, and hopefully my message will get through. We'll see you in a little while as soon as power comes back. Yes, check that kudu bull. I've never seen a kudu bull lying down like that. Not quite. He's just that shows how hot it is. I mean, to have a kudu bull lying down with his head flat on the ground like that. I mean, there's another one. Sadly, he's behind bushes. It's got a little bit forward. We were stopped to the side. Can you? Having a go with the bushes.
Oh, no, I'm looking at another one.
Oh, the other one lying down. Hopefully, you're still with us. I hope you're still with us. Know how long it takes for them to switch off power. Now we're in the sun, but still, there we go. Another kudu bull lying down in the shade, and one kudu bull feeling that youngster. Horribly energetic for this time of the day in this heat. Getting his horns into a tree and a little bit of displacement aggression. A little bit of sparring. Water. Patrick, come in. Much for going back to Gari, just as well. It could be that maybe now they're only working on a section of line for Vuyatela and not for Yuri's house, and we still seem to be fine, which is very good news. I wonder if we can maybe just find a spot in the shade to watch these kudu, because we're cooking here. Temperature at the moment is only about 34, 35 degrees in the shade, but sitting here in the sun pushes it up to above 40, which is well over 100. Let's see, let's do this. Just pop off here into the shade. Oh, look at that bull up on the termite mound. Another two bulls approaching that same termite mound. We've got some wonderful kudu bulls here at the moment. I think a lot of us know this particular group of bulls. Right, there's six of them. The two groups of three that have come back together again. That is not a very common sight to see so many kudu bulls together. So wonderful, so majestic, and so, well, just such big bulls. I think we must be very lucky to have them as, I guess we could call them residents, since we see at least some of them all the time. The game drive's coming out already. Warren, come in. Is power out at Weir's?
That's what I know.
Sorry, go again? I thought you said you were switching off.
I'm switching on.
Oh, okay, thanks. I could have sworn he said switching off. Alright, well, let's head out. Come back this way a little later. Well, that explains why we got picture. Honestly, could have sworn Warren said switching power off. I was confused that we had power and it was supposed to have been off. But still, we're lucky. As you can see, jigger's looking pretty good, steering sounding solid. And right now, I think not much stands in our way other than a few impala. Morning, everybody. Hello, kids. Nursery group here in the shade. All these little ones just learning about what vehicles are for the first time in their lives, or I guess some of them have seen us for a few times, but I think they get ignored so much, I think it's unusual for them to see the vehicle stop and look at them. On my right in the shade are all the females feeding and replenishing their milk supplies in some of the thicker bush. All these youngsters corralled together into a little nursery group. That kudu from here. Thanks, Kay. Kay's saying that the one that was lying down is an older bull, thinking about moving to Michigan. Excuse me, children, I just want to go back because he's actually just stood up and all of these bulls are starting to move now. Sorry, kids. Some of the youngsters are starting to move across the road behind us back to their moms. That's the bull that was lying down, that big one, standing high in the sun.
Oh, there's another one lying down.
Oh, he hasn't stood up yet, that one that's lying down. He's the one that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and the one on the termite mound 6. What I want to do is I want to head way west, being such a hot afternoon. Let's head way up to Impala Plains, or rather Sandy Patch first. Go look for some Ellie tracks up there, and then make our way to the east so that we've got the sun behind us for most of the afternoon. And perhaps later when we come back this way, these boys will still be around quarantine. Just want to move out of the road. Look at that, sorry, just one more shot. Those three together. I'll be hiding one of them. I'm so enthralled by these kudus. I think they're so amazing. Another one standing up because all the rest of the boys are moving on. But it is very, very hot here, so we want to just get a bit of airflow. Maybe a bit later we'll come by and see if they're still around. Hi, Kathy. Kathy was just asking if there's a purpose to the stamping of the front feet. I think if I understand correctly, and we see Impala doing it, all these youngsters are now lying down. The nursery group, they all relaxed again. Hey little one, out of the road. Can your mother tell you not to play in the road? I've seen horses do it as well. I mean, I always thought it was just to chase off biting flies. The stomping of the legs. I don't think there's any behavioral purpose to it. But I guess I may be wrong there. I'll have to watch a lot closer and see if I can interpret some other meaning to it. Talk about being wrong. We've got to set the record straight from last night's drive when I stopped for that flower. That what I said was a devil's thorn was actually a devil's claw, and pointed out to me by Lynn in Canada. I always thought, being the same family, I just thought it was also one of the devil's thorns, and just a darker flower, a little bit denser, or rather a little bit bigger flower, not as dainty. I've actually marked it in my book, funnily enough.